champion. At the 1968 Olympic Games in Mexico City, Věra Čáslavská of Czechoslovakia was the grand dame of the sport. She had already celebrated winning the all-around for the second straight Olympic Games. With this vault, she began her quest for four individual gold medals.
And that was a near-perfect vault.
She won the vault and the unevens easily, but then a controversial decision by the judges cost her the gold on the beam. It appeared there was more going on here than sport itself. 2 months earlier, the Soviet army had overrun Czáslavská's homeland of Czechoslovakia.
These are the floor exercises. Four girls within one-tenth of a point going into the final here, a gold medal on the line.
And here, politics would enter the games for the second time, for when Soviet Larisa Petrick finished, her score of 9-9 gave her a total score just behind the leaders. Indeed, as Czáslavská stood poised on the mat, the last to perform, it was Kuczynskaya she thought she had to beat, and a 9-9 would do it.
Oh, a beautiful, high, full-twisting back somersault. The best in this competition.
The Mexican hat dance is not calculated to displease the audience here in Mexico City.
They love it. Jim, that's a 10 if I've ever seen it. Perfect exercise.
The Jam National Auditorium in Mexico City awarding by their applause the gold medal to Vera Czáslavská. She got the 9-9. Czáslavská has won her fourth gold medal.
Or at least that's what she thought.
We return to the National Auditorium. The officials have changed the figures that were given out before this event going into the final round. They have corrected the previous score of Larisa Petrick and have announced that it is a tie for the gold medal between Věra Čáslavská of Czechoslovakia and Larisa Petrick of the Soviet Union.
What had just transpired was almost unheard of. After the event, officials announced that they'd been wrong all along, that Petrick's preliminary scores should have been higher entering the finals. So now Czáslavská would have to share the moment that was to have been hers alone.
And now the Soviet anthem. And again, she has turned her head to the right and down, just as she did at the last ceremony. This does not appear to be an accident.
Clearly, it was an act of public defiance in the face of Soviet tanks that had so recently crushed the Czechoslovakian uprising. Her act carried a personal price. She returned home to find herself an official outcast, forced to live in relative isolation, her career finished. But among her countrymen, Věra Čáslavská became a national heroine for publicly defying the Soviets while the world watched.